Great. Hello, welcome to Sacramento State University, the Doctorate in Educational Leadership. I'm Julian Vasquez-Heilig, professor of Educational Leadership and Policy Studies, and director of the Doctorate in Educational Leadership. This is the second in our series about getting ready for graduate school, surviving graduate school. The first episode in this series occurred a few weeks back, where we interviewed some of the alums of our program, the Doctorate in Educational Leadership here at California State University, Sacramento. Today, we've actually brought together a womanal, you know, like they say manal, panel, womanal, a womanal of leaders from our cohort 10. It's our 10th cohort here at Sacramento State, to talk about surviving graduate school. We're actually going to address the same questions with them that we did in our first alumni panel. Also, just a sneak peek. Coming up, we will have a third and final panel of faculty from Sacramento State's Doctorate in Educational Leadership. That will occur on Friday at the same time, 12:30 on Friday, June the 16th. So join us for our third and final Surviving Graduate School panel on June the 16th. So I'll go ahead and turn over the microphone to our three students. Let them quickly introduce themselves and tell you about what they're doing right now. And then we'll roll right into our questions. We have about five questions that they're going to address.
Hi, my name is Karen Bridges. I'm working as an instructional coach, and I'm looking at using this program to help me with my practice.
Great, great.
And I'm Susie Dollison, and I'm working as an education programs consultant, and I'm looking at utilizing my doctorate for advancing in my career.
Great. My name is Iqbal Nuruddin. I'm working at the meantime as a substitute teacher because I'm a newcomer here in the States. So I'm looking forward to finish my EdD and maybe apply for a job, educational job, in the field of education.
Great, great. Thank you to each of you for being here. So one of the difficult things about graduate school, whether you're at Cal State or Stanford or Michigan or anywhere really, is managing your time, right? Everyone has competing priorities, competing activities. So tell us each and, you know, how you manage your time, and whoever wants to go first, how do you manage your time?
Well, I try first concerning my, I usually visit my family every day, or especially my mom. During this, when I started my EdD, I just call her every day, and maybe I visit her one day every or three times a week. I try to do my usual chores, but when I take break, I usually study for or my readings and my things that I usually do for my assignments. But during my breaks, I usually do my chores. So I try to divide my time in a way to finish all the assignments, but because we have lots of readings and lots of writings to do. So that's it.
So you find balance with your family, with your home responsibilities, and the work that you have related to your different courses.
Yeah, otherwise we would not be able to finish all
that. So it sounds like what you do is you find a schedule and you say, I set aside this time for family, I set aside this time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I look at it as balance, and I also look at it as collaboration. So my husband chips in the housework and the chores. We start dividing a little bit more with my daughter and then with work. But it is having the balance and having scheduled times where I have to say, no, this hour I have to just be able to read.
Mm-hmm.
And then the work demands and then the family demands and making sure that there is scheduled time mm-hmm. for the coursework.
So it sounds like you make some deals with your partner.
I did.
With your kids.
I did.
I'm going to do this, so sign here.
Yes. Okay. We just say it's temporary. We'll make it through.
We'll make it work. Okay.
Make it work.
And I kind of did the same thing, like, before I came, you know, I kind of talked to my kids and told them, you know, exactly what I was doing, how long it was going to be. And so we kind of have a schedule. And so I have a schedule that's up in the house, and we go and write down everything that we have to do, you know, this whole time management. And I actually schedule time for myself. So mm-hmm. I think scheduling that time for yourself actually helps you to be able to manage the other things mm-hmm. as well. And for me, you know, making sure that the kids also have their chore list and mm-hmm. things like that. And, you know, it just gives me purpose, and it also gives them purpose. Mm-hmm. So that was the biggest thing.
One of the interesting things that really stuck with me about this question when the alumni answered it mm-hmm. was one of the alums said, don't give up everything that makes you you, mm-hmm. right?
Right.
You know, if you bike, don't give that up completely.
Yeah.
If you like to watch Netflix, zombie mm-hmm. movies, that's me. Don't give that up completely, right?
Yeah.
You want to keep you, too, right? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Not to a certain extent, because
yes.
sometimes we have to limit. I usually exercise every day. I go walk for
mm-hmm.
about half an hour and a half.
Mm-hmm.
During this program,
mm-hmm.
I have to stop and do it, let's say, 3 times a week,
right.
not every day.
Right.
So,
okay,
yeah.
So you scaled down, but you
yeah.
still kept it,
yeah, yeah.
kept your exercise routine.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what do you feel are some of the stressful aspects of graduate school? And how do you handle the stress related to graduate school? I think about when I was a graduate student at
mm-hmm.
Stanford, I had a lot of stress.
Mm-hmm.
I had a lot of, and I was a full-time student. I didn't have to deal with a lot of the other things that you have when you're mid-career.
Mm-hmm.
So what's stressful about graduate school? And how do you deal with that stress?
For me, the stress is coming with, you know, having to do my work, plus having to do the work for graduate school, and basically losing sleep. So, you know, you lose sleep and you get less sleep, and so you just have to learn how to deal with it. And for me, that's really stressful because I'm the type of person who needs my 8 hours, and so I have to learn how to have less sleep and, you know, do things a little more purposeful so that, you know, I'll get, you know, it's done. But it, that's really stressful for me.
I think one of the things that I found as a graduate student, too, is that we start